So that's it. We have some asphalt in the city, and then we have only dirt road. We started already. If it's like that, it's fine. It is 9:30. We'll see where we can get today. So this main road is some kind of bumpy old cover. So we're gonna take this, which is going alternatively beside the road. It's a little sandy, but it's much better and much smoother, because the one on the bottom, it's really bumpy. I hope we're gonna have the cover like this until Altai. If not, we'll do whatever we have. Unfortunately, it's finished for a while, and we came here to this really bumpy part, but I can go here to this. Yeah, we'll see where it's going. I hope in the right direction. Yeah, let's see, Dima. We can have some speed in this wild open area. Look at all of these goats. So many animals here. I think it's the country with the biggest number of animals. But unfortunately, this road is ended, and then we have to go to the bumpy part again. Anyway, whatever we gain, it's a bonus. Yeah. This is a great place to ride. I just want to make a picture from here, because it's so nice. So nice. Look at this. Look at this. So down on the bottom is Ulistai, and this is the road we just took, and we'll go up to the hill. Let me tell you something really funny. So for this trip we were prepared with two contour cameras, as mine, and one GoPro to Dima. And we thought that we're gonna have three cameras, so we can make a much better movies. And so on and so on. But what is actually happens, it's the first camera contour fell down, break down, I don't know what exactly is happening, and it stopped working. So we have left one. The first one, the one break down, was waterproof. The one I use now is not waterproof. So yesterday we have a full day of rain, and we cannot cover anything because we have to keep the camera in good condition. Also, Dima has GoPro, but Dima is this type of guy who is not really focused on that. He's a great guy to ride with, but for cameras or stuff like that, he is just, how I have to say, I have to cover everything. Here we go, Dima is came. He's riding slowly in his own pace. I'm not gonna push him to ride fast. The important part here is to go back safe. And if he feels safe on that speed, let it be. I'm not that type of person to push everybody to ride as fast as possible. If he feels alright, it's okay. And anyway, when you ride on this speed, you can really enjoy your ride. You can see everything around you. It is so nice and beautiful. After the crappy raining day, moody day yesterday, today, guys, is just outstanding. It's amazing. We've got this beautiful mountain pass to cover. The weather is nice. It is 15 degrees sunny. And we have this absolutely amazing landscapes around us. It's a great day for riding. After yesterday, we really deserve it. Well, this is what I will expect to see from Mongolia, and this is what exactly we have at the moment. It is so nice and beautiful. You see how the road is going all the way down to the bottom, and miles away, it's nothing. So the first city is going to be something like 100 kilometers from here. So wild. So finally, we have a big result now. Dima install his GoPro. Well, we are in the middle of the trip and he installed his GoPro just now because I asked him to do it. And as you can see, guys, you have at the end when we made the video, we're gonna have so much footage from me shooting Dima and nothing from Dima shooting me. I don't care, I don't mind, I don't want to see myself on the camera. But it's going to be much, much better for you if you have a different perspective, finally, when we make the video. But anyway, Dima is a great guy to ride with, but to deal with cameras, shootings or stuff like that, just forget about it. We really enjoyed the road today. I hope it will stay the same until the end of the day. We planned to cover about 200 kilometers. But if everything going well, if we can cover more, will be great. We'll keep moving. I just want to show you guys how these real nomadic families are living. Just to show you how modern the world became. So this is the typical nomadic family, nomads. So they have this, their yurts, they have a satellite dish, they have a solar panel and car next to it. This is what I explained so many times. The world is changed now. They living in the middle of nowhere, but you see, solar panels, antenna, car is there, satellite dish and all of this stuff. I just want to show you everything. It's so nice to be here. Irak? No? No Irak? No. Okay. Hello. You see, they have 1, 2, 3, 4 kids, 5 kids, 6 kids. This is Mongolia. So these people have this yurt and they load everything on the trailer and move and looking for a better place for the animals. So 6 kids. No Irak? Irak? Drink? No? Okay. So I want to try this traditional drink. Name is Irak. It's made from a horse, from the female horse milk. But they don't have it. So Dima is waiting for me over there, so we go. Okay. Ciao, ciao. It was just great to have this on the camera, just to show you, because you have to see it to believe it. If not, it's going to be difficult for me to explain you what exactly it is. But anyway, now you know. The road is, it's bumpy, but it's not bad. The weather is great. The landscapes are fantastic around us. The temperature is about 19 degrees already, so our clothes can get dry from yesterday, and everything is absolutely perfect. Such a funny road to ride. Where exactly is the road? We don't know. You just follow the one you like. So nice. So we really enjoy our trips today. I just tried to catch this big eagles or whatever it is. I don't know what exactly it is. You see the locals with these small motorcycles, they travel everywhere around. What?
What?
Ah, okay. Some kind of...
Hi.
Do you speak English? Okay. So this is some kind of sanitary inspection. Ah, it's funny. It is so funny.
Where are you from?
Bulgaria.
Bulgaria.
Bulgaria. Bulgaria.
Bulgaria.
Bulgaria. Bulgaria. Bulgaria. Oh, there is a police here. It's a very, very important. I can go.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. We go there. Altay. Çugrik. It's all about money. All about money. Аз дам и за двамата. For both. Okay. I don't know why they constantly asking for money. For...
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay, 1000 на калпак, мисля. Каре, каквото и да е толкова. So, 1000 to Greek to pass this point. Ah, funny. Really funny. Pay for highways, or I don't know what we are paying for. Anyway, man. Sanitary inspection. They don't have roads, but they really spread out our bikes. Another one inspection. Теско е? Ще напръскат тука. Чакай да ви покажа аз. Окей. No money this time. Трябва да дойш тука. The road is constantly changing from rocks to sand, from sand to rocks. So actually we're testing the bikes in any conditions. I think Dima start to push, but it is not the right moment to push. These sharp stones can really penetrate your tire and bend your wheel. I have a problem with my throttle handle. It's moving inside, so I have to fix it.
Трябва пак. Аз имам друго. Той без това вече, не знам дали че мога да стане.
Кой това бялото?
Такива лентички.
За какво са?
М?
За какво са?
Абе, така са направили ръкохватките.
Си едно ще се написа за крос.
Разбуди се, ти видях таз. Давай газ, Митя, направо не мога да спреш.
We just made short 10-15 minutes break. It's so peaceful here. Dima, what do you think about this road?
Excellent ride for off-road in Mongolia.
Exactly what you're looking for. Yeah, this is a great ride here. Great ride. it's a nice open space. Duma is not coming, so I will come back to see. Is he okay? I see him. Okay, maybe he has some kind of problem. Коста!
Машина лесно?
Ми на лесно не, на дъното на багажа. Коста! Шайба някаква голяма? Чакай, аз ма имам. So nothing serious. This protector just move around. We're gonna try to fix it now. The problem is fixed and we can go. Thank you very much for watching and don't forget to subscribe for a new video every week. Ride safe. Ciao.